Hey there, it's Kaylee, and in this lesson, we're going to learn to calculate the surface area of solid figures, like cubes and right prisms. We've learned how to find the area of 2D shapes, like squares and triangles. But now we need to find the surface area of 3D shapes, like cubes and prisms. The surface area is the area of all the faces on a solid figure added together. It can be tricky to think about finding the area of all the faces of a solid object, especially when we can't even see all the faces. So here I have a rectangular prism. If I want to find the surface area of this rectangular prism, I need to find the area of each face. So let's take the faces apart. Here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have 6 different faces. But do you notice anything about these faces? Yeah, there's only 3 different shapes. There's 2 of these blue ones, 2 of these green faces, and 2 of these pink faces. So I would just need to find the area of these faces and then add it all together to have the surface area of the entire rectangular prism. Well, we can't take the sides apart like in our last example, but we can use a net to help us visualize our solid figure. A net is a drawing that shows the flattened out version of our figure. Our cube would have a net that looks like this. We have our square bases here, and then our 4 sides are here. Remember, this is a cube, so that means all 6 sides are congruent squares. So to find the surface area of our cube, we need to find the sum of the area of all 6 squares. So now if I know one side length of my square is 2 inches, then I know all of the side lengths are 2 inches. So I could find the area of one square by saying 2 inches times 2 inches, which is equal to 4 inches squared. So this is 4 inches squared. And since this is a cube, I know that each of these sides and bases are all congruent. So their areas are all 4 inches squared. So to find the surface area, I would just have to add up all of the areas, or find the sum of all of the areas of all 6 sides. So I'd have 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 would give me my surface area. Or I could say 4 inches squared times 6, because that's the same thing, will give me 24 inches squared as my surface area. Nice job. So here I have a square prism. That means my bases are squares and it looks like my sides are rectangles. So my net will look like this. I have 4 rectangles and 2 squares. Now if I want to find the surface area, I will need to find the sum of the area of the 2 square bases and add it to the sum of the area of the 4 rectangular sides. Lucky for us, we know the formula for finding the area of squares and rectangles is length times width. So if I know that my squares have a side length of 2 and my rectangles have a side length of 6, I can find the area of my base would be 2 inches times 2 inches, which is 4 inches squared. So that's both of those there. And then if I know that this side here is also equal to 2 inches, then the area of my rectangle is equal to 6 inches times 2 inches, and that gives me 12 inches squared. So that's going to be the same for all of these. So now what would I have to do? I have to add up all of these areas together. Or I can find the surface area of my bases is equal to 2 times 4 inches squared, which is equal to 8 inches squared. And the surface area of my sides is equal to 4 times 12 inches squared. 4 times 12, that gives me 48 inches squared. And now all I have to do is find the sum of these here. So 48 plus 8, that gives me 56 inches squared. And that would be the total surface area of my square prism. Now, what about a triangular prism? What would it look like flattened out? This triangular prism would have two triangle bases and three rectangle sides. So the surface area would be the sum of the area of the triangles plus the sum of the area of the rectangles. All right, so let's find the area for my base here. It's a triangle, so I have base times height. Base is 2 inches times my height, 1.7 inches, divided by 2. That gives me 3.4 inches squared divided by 2. That's going to be equal to 1.7 inches squared. So that's the area for this base and 1.7 inches squared over here. Now, what's the area for one of my sides, one of these rectangles? I have 3 inches times 2 inches. 3 inches times 2 inches, that gives me 6 inches squared. So that means all of these are 6 inches squared as well. So the surface area of my bases, I have two triangles that each have an area of 1.7 inches squared. So that gives me a total of 3.4 inches squared. And my rectangles give me a surface area of my sides of 3 times 6 inches squared, and that is equal to 18.0 inches squared. And if I find my sum here, I bring down my 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, carry my 1, 2, and I bring my decimal point down, inches squared. So that's the total surface area for this triangular prism. Great work learning how to use nets to calculate the surface area of cubes and prisms. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.